Committee Chairman Jason Smith sending subpoenas to four FBI and IRS officials involved with the Hunter Biden tax probe. The committee say the officials were either present or have direct knowledge of an October 2022 meeting in which Delaware U.S. Attorney David Weiss allegedly said he was prevented from bringing tax charges against Hunter Biden. So Jordan released a statement saying that Americans deserve to know the truth, especially now that Attorney General Merrick Garland has appointed Weiss as special counsel in the investigation. I want to bring in Virginia Congressman Ben Klein. He's a member of the House Judiciary Appropriations and Budget Committees. Congressman, your response to these subpoenas, and it looks like more information is needed about this particular meeting.
Well, the committees of jurisdiction, the Ways and Means Committee, the Judiciary Committee, the Oversight Committee are all taking aggressive action to get the facts, methodically working to get results for the American people. And the information, the truth is coming out about just how involved Merrick Garland's DOJ was in the preparation of this sweetheart deal for Hunter Biden.
You know, it's interesting because the New York Post has an op-ed out this morning, and it says that the media hides it, but Biden's in big trouble because Americans are getting wind of the nothing burger, meaning that more and more Americans now are realizing that potentially President Biden, then Vice President Biden, was compromised and was aiding and his son in particular to get these sweetheart deals from Burisma and others.
Tens of millions of dollars flowing to the Biden family. I don't talk about just Hunter Biden anymore. I'm talking about the entire Biden family and the collusion that went on, not just the collusion between the Biden administration and the media, but you also have the collusion going on between DOJ and now the Hunter Biden attorney, Mr. Clark, the efforts by Mr. Clark to get access to DOJ attorneys. You have Merrick Garland saying that Mr. Weiss was independent, but at the same time, they're granting these meetings only a week after these IRS whistleblowers come forward saying, we don't have the ability to get access to these Hunter Biden files like we want to. So the Judiciary Committee, the Oversight Committee, the Ways and Means Committee are getting the facts for the American people, and we're going to follow the facts wherever they lead because the Judiciary Committee has that responsibility.
Well, and to be clear, I mean, it is these whistleblowers that are now being credited with the fact that that plea deal, which was such a sweetheart deal for Hunter Biden, really blew up in front of the judge. Back to the drawing board, if you will. We'll see what David Weiss does. I want to bring up this with you. Data from the Household Pulse surveys finds nearly 87 million Americans say it is somewhat or very difficult to pay for household expenses. That is up 6 million from January of 2021. Let's remember, that was President Biden's first month as president, yet the president is running for re-election on Bidenomics, Congressman.
Well, Bidenomics just means you pay more and or you get less. And so inflation as a result of Biden's policies has cost the average American family $700 a month. I know most families in America don't have $700 a month extra that they can afford to pay for these Biden policies. And so we've got a lot of work to do in Congress to get control of our budgets, rein in spending, bring inflation under control, and get back to responsible fiscal management. And that's what the House of Representatives under Republican control is trying to do.
You also have a budget fight. Looks like it's going to be here again before you know it. The House Freedom Caucus has released their demands for any future government funding bills. Here's the statement. We refuse to support any measure that continues Democrats' bloated COVID-era spending and fails to force the Biden administration to follow the law. Congressman, here is what they're asking for. They will oppose any bill that does not include the Secure the Border Act of 2023. They say they have to address the weaponization of the DOJ and FBI. They want to end woke policies in the Pentagon, and they're definitely questioning the $24 billion that President Biden is asking for Ukraine. Basically, this blank check, if you will. Your reaction to their demands?
I think all of those demands are popular with the American people. These are the things that American people are asking for when they put Republicans in charge. We're just using the power of the purse to make sure that we deliver on our priorities when it comes to these policies. We don't want a continuing resolution that just simply continues Nancy Pelosi's spending policies. That's not what the American people wanted in November, and that's what we need to get to.
But look, Kevin McCarthy already last week, is already talking about getting, he wants to get this CR through earlier. Look, it doesn't seem like there's a lot of excitement about another big budget fight on Capitol Hill that goes to the end. And remember, that is why the credit rating of this country was downgraded. The rating agencies are saying that the budget fights are hurting the economic state of the federal government.
The budget fights are what happens when you have a republic, you have divided government. That's part of the process. But what you don't or shouldn't have is $33 trillion in debt and deficits running at $1 trillion a year. That's what the credit agencies talked about when they issued those downgrades. And so you have an administration that is ignoring these credit agencies, continuing to demand spending at these record deficit levels. It can't continue. It's going to drive inflation back up. Fuel prices, food prices, agriculture prices for farmers. We can't continue on the road that we've been on. We have to change our spending habits.
And I think a lot of people agree with you. I think that it's the, again, it's the